بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. الحمد لله, we finished علم البيان. Just to summarize علم البيان. So we said علم البيان, is it علم المعاني first? Then we go to علم البيان. علم البيان, we said there are three sections. تشبيه is to draw, تشبيه is called what? Simile. You draw a similitude between two things. Then مجاز is, can be metaphors or it can be, there's another name for it, metonymy, I think. So two types of مجاز. So tashbih is to draw a comparison between A and B. Majaz is when A is removed and you use B, but you mean A. And kinaya is when you say A and you can mean B, but it's also possible that A is also included. Okay? So if you look at it here. This is everything we did in tashbih. So we said, we had three separate discussions, mabahath. In the first one, we discussed the arkan. Oh, the arkan? You have tarafan, the mushabba and mushabba bihi, two elements. Correct? And these two can be hissi, aqli, or mukhtalif. Both hissi, both aqli, or they can be one hissi, one aqli. Correct? Yeah. Then you have adat tashbih. And the adat is kaf ka'anna fa'il. So kaf ka'anna any fa'il, ushbihu ya. Okay? Something like this. So these are the tools which can be used to express the meaning of tashbih. And then you have wajhu shabba. So you have two taraf, one adat and one wajah. You have four arkan of tashbih. Correct? Then we are on and say later on, if you do taqseem of the tashbih, you can mufrad bi mufrad, mufrad bi murakkab, murakkab bi mufrad, murakkab bi murakkab. According to the mushabba mushabba bihi. Then according to how many they are they two or more? If they're two or more, if they're both two, it's either malfuf or mafruq. If they're uneven numbers, tasbih and jama'. Malfuf means what? When they all mix together. Mushabba, mushabba, mushabbabi, mushabbabi, is entwined. And mafruq is mushabba, mushabbabihi, mushabba, mushabbabihi, separate. And taswi and jama' is when what? One, mushabbabihi is more than one, and mushabba is one. Or the opposite way around. Then you have tamthi, the word mushabba. Is a shabba in one element, or is it more than one element? If it's more than one element, come the tamthil. And if it's just one element, called ghay tamthil. Correct? Mufassal is regarding the word mushabba. Is the word shabba mentioned or not? If it's mentioned, you call it mufassal. If it's not mentioned, you call it mujman. And this is regarding the adat tashbih. Adat tashbih is mentioned, you call it mursal. It's not mentioned, you call it mu'akkad. And if it's mujman and mu'akkad, you call it tashbihun baligh. And just for your knowledge, so for example, in English, if you say zaydun asadun, in Arabic, what is this? Zaydun asadun? Tashbihun? But in Arabic, okay. Yeah? I'll do that shortly, yeah? And then why do you bring tashbih? There are many purposes of tashbih. To show a possibility, the state, the amount, the state of the mushabba, state of... So all of these different things. So the taqreer, the tazeen, taqbih. All of these are the reasons. You can have many other reasons as well. So this is what we discuss in tashbih. The first section of ilm al-bayan. Then within majaz, in this table before, we go through again. So the majaz means what? You use a word in its non-literal meaning. So instead of using a word literally, you use it figuratively. If the majaz, not the real meaning, is in the lafz, or it can mean isnad. Okay? If it's in the isnad, call it majaz al-aqli. Meaning what? You attribute something to who it's not really belonging to. Like Fir'aun killed the children. Meaning, he didn't do it, he ordered it. So by attributing killing to Fir'aun, it's what? Majaz al-aqli. You say the spring brought forth the crops, majaz al-aqli. Because the one bringing it forth is what? So for example, for a believer, this is majaz al-aqli. And for an atheist, this is what? Haqiqi. It's not majazi in there. You get it? Because according to his belief, it's real. It's not God. So to him, it's okay. The spring actually brings forth the crops. Okay? Another discussion, anyway. Now, when the majaz is in the lafz, a word is used in its non literal meaning, in a figurative meaning. It's either one word is used out of place or a whole structure. If it's one word, it can be isti'ara. If what? The link, the bridge between the figurative, the literal meaning and the figurative meaning is tashbih. And then this can be all of these. Musarraha, makniya, asliya, tabi'iya, murashya, mujarrada, and mutlaqa. It's three different taqseems. Musarraha, makniya, asliya, tabi'iya, murashya, mujarrada, mutlaqa. And this all came in the previous discussions. And if the link between the literal meaning and the figurative meaning is not tashbih, it's not similar, a comparison, you call it mursal. Correct? And if the reason you're using a word, the whole structure, the whole sentence is being used in its non-original meaning, that's called madaz al-murakkab. Okay? But you don't call it mu'arak. This you don't label this, but this is what it really means. And if it's an isti'ara, the tashbih, you call it isti'ara tamthiliya. And if it's a non-comparison reason, like insha in khabar meaning, or amar in khabar meaning, or khabar in istifham meaning, this is majaz murakkab. Okay? You follow? And as I said, tashbih and isti'ara, even though here they're separate. The separate of tashbih, majaz. But tashbih and majaz, as I said, majaz isti'ara is an off branch and it moves on, develops from the tashbih. So you have tashbih and a tashbih and baligh. So in English, in Arabic, tashbih what stops here? Yeah? So if you have tashbih, you have mushabba bihi, and wajhu and adatu tashbih. That's called tashbih and mursal or mujmal. Oh, sorry, mufassal. When tashbih baligh happens when? When you say? Zaydun Asadun. You remove the wajhu shabba and the adatu tashbih. So up until here, you have what? Two elements. And from here onwards, you have what? One element. Only the what? Mushabba bihi. But in English, they also call this what? Metaphor. Is that a metaphor of a meme? Metaphor. So even tashbih baligh is a metaphor in English. So even some Arab scholars have debated is tashbih baligh metaphor or not. Is that majaz or not? Okay? But from so basically, from here tashbih ends and from here majaz starts. In English, you call it metaphor from here onwards. Okay? Yeah. And then if you have two elements, if the element is mentioned explicitly, call it what? Isti'ara musarraha. Mushabba bihi. And even more eloquent than that, we go to maqniya. Where you don't even mention mushabba bihi, you mention the lazim mushabba bihi. Okay? And the third one is kinaya. What does kinaya mean? You use a word, you don't really mean the exact meaning, even though the literal meaning is possible. And it's three taqseems. You do kinaya in mawsuf, kinaya in sifa, kinaya in nisbah. Correct? That's one division, a categorization. The other categorization is what? How far away, or how far is the figurative meaning from the literal meaning? If it's qareeb, then it's either the meaning is obvious, you call it ishara. If it's not obvious, it's a bit vague or very complex, you call it ramz. And if from the original meaning, literal meaning, the figurative meaning is very, very far-fetched. Like Jabal al-Kalb. He's got a coward dog. Or he's lots of ash. Then it's called talbih. And then some people have mentioned that one type of kinaya is called what? Ta'rif.
Okay, that makes sense.
So you understand? That's a summary of what we have done in ilmul bayan. You following?
He has been slaughtered without a knife.
Okay. Any questions regarding this? Questions? What do you understand? Subhanallah, bihamdi, subhanakallahumma, wa bihamdika, nashhadu la ilaha illa anta, wa nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.